been a great person for me as coach. I came in nearly 9 years ago and we made him captain, and every time I've asked him to be the player, he's just always done it for us. And that's all you can mark people by. When you need them, he's there.
And both goals.
Yeah, he was a wonderful person to coach.
It might be the breakout game for Travis Boak.
He was always a leader. He is selfless. He always gives to the club first. But at the same time, I love the fact that he gets out there and plays tough footy.
Smothered Boak with a big collision.
Trav's a long way from done. I think he's planning on playing his 400th, not just his 300th.
Inspirational!
He's a fantastic person and been also equally a great player.
The storied career of Travis Boak, who on Friday night will become just the second Port Adelaide player to reach that 300-game milestone, which is so front of mind right now. Trav, congratulations. Great to have you on AFL 360.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. And it's great to be on.
Do you have an idea in your mind what 300 represents to you early in the week?
It's a great honour, I think, to represent this footy club for one game. Is a huge honour, and to put on the Port Adelaide Guernsey. To do it in 300 games is something I haven't really thought about too much and never really dreamt of doing, but it's certainly something I'll look back on. And for me right now, I'm just so grateful to be able to play for this footy club and for the club to support me for so long and give me the opportunity and the fans and everyone who's been along the journey. It's been an incredible ride.
So how big a part is the footy club in your life, Trav?
Oh, it's huge for me. I think, obviously, moving over here as a young kid, not knowing too much about SA at a pretty difficult time for our family and for them to welcome me in, to welcome my family in, and what they've been able to do for, not only me but my family along the whole way has been incredible, and there's no way that I would have been able to achieve what I've been able to achieve without the support of the footy club. And Friday night's going to be more about the footy club than me and what they've been able to do for me.
It's a precedent for Friday nights and 300. You've got to kick six. You realise that?
Yeah, Jack set a fair precedent there, but I'm not sure I'll be able to match that. But hopefully we get the W, which is all we'll be after.
How have you changed? I mean, this modern day of footy now, we are part of the journey, whether you guys like it or not. It's such a public profile. I mean, over in Adelaide, it'd be much more front of mind than perhaps it is here. But how have you changed throughout the course of this 300-game journey?
I think certainly over the last probably 4 or 5 years, I've matured a lot more and accepted what comes with AFL football. And, I think trying to fight back, the whole media and what you can't control and fans' opinions and all that is something that can probably distract you from performance. And I think for me, over the journey, it's about accepting all the distractions that come with it and just allowing myself to be the best person I can, the best footballer I can, and help my teammates as much as I can and focus on what I can control. And that's basically kind of what I've learnt, certainly over the last little period as an older player.
I think you're the poster boy for the modern day player in terms of your acceptance of the things that you spoke about. I read a lot of stuff today about, letting go of ego and the mindfulness training that you do. And I mean, you've got so much to offer. Do you see that in a young group coming through now? I mean, so many young players on this list. Are you sharing that journey with them early to try and shortcut any of those issues they may have?
Yeah, and I think that's the beauty of it is being able to learn this stuff, but then being able to share it with others and certainly young guys coming through. And I think it's society, it's not just AFL at this stage about, really just focusing on what we can control. And I mean, the environment we're in at the moment with COVID and what's happening in lockdowns everywhere, it's, so much of it is out of our control and creates so much anxiety and stress. And for us and for me now, it's about sharing what I've learned, certainly with our younger players. And they're so open now to learning more about the mental side of footy and not just the physical side of it. And that's what's going to take them for hopefully long, successful careers.
So 300 is a moment to mark excellence and longevity and to watch sort of the late career peak, the second peak that you've had. So last year, all the way to runner-up in a Brownlow and none too shabby this year either. What's been
the secret to the, to, I guess, the second wave late in a career?
I think a lot of what we just spoke about in terms of letting go and just having fun. I think that's the most important thing. We can get so caught up in what we do and, you know, the performance and outcome side of thing that we lose a lot of enjoyment. And I think for me over the last several years, definitely I've enjoyed it so much more. I guess the journey from captain to now post-captaincy is something that's has been quite enjoyable and still try and be a leader as best I can. But certainly learned so much from the leadership side of things and probably things I would have done a lot differently, but, you know, wouldn't change it for the world. It's, you know, something now that I can share to the younger guys who are trying to become leaders of the footy club and just the enjoyment around the group. We've got such a fantastic group at the footy club and they just want to learn and get better and be the best they can every day. And being a part of that is something that I really enjoy and I think that's helped my footy a lot.
You very generously shared the story of your dad with us previously. Will he be in your mind on Friday night? And what do you reckon he'd make of it?
Yeah, there's no doubt. I'll certainly look up to the sky when I run out in the ground. And I know that he'll be watching. And look, he's started the journey for me. You know, Dad and Mum, growing up in Torquay, they were the ones that gave me the opportunity to I guess, blossom in a footy career and learn so much from them as a footballer and you know, but most importantly as a person. And there's no doubt that Friday night will be just as much about him and as it will, you know, the rest of my family. And yeah, I can't be more grateful for what I've learnt from Dad and Mum and my sisters as well. And that's what it's going to be about Friday night. And I'm really excited for that.
Got all the merchandise here. You're not getting any of it back. Gerard just wants a G-string from your Rogers underwear range. He reckons a little G-banger might go nicely.
I'll send that over in the post. I think that'll go well with one of those white T-shirts. A white G-string, white T-shirt for you, Gerard.
Have you had a little hand in designing these?
The club did have a chat to me about it, but they did most of the work. It's come up really good. And the beauty of it all is that the $2 from each item will go to childhood cancer here in SA, the charity I've been working with for a number of years. So that's that'll be amazing. But yeah, hopefully a lot of people can get out there and buy it and support that great charity and support the guys on Friday night.
Perfect. Back in the top four, does the burn for a premiership still fuel you?
Yeah, it's alive and well. There's no doubt. I think, you know, it's certainly been a challenge this year, obviously, for everyone with injuries, but we've faced a few and, you know, our guys have been able to really fight and certainly we showed that on the weekend. You know, there was a lot happening outside of our control with, you know, travelling on the same day, not knowing what time the game was until later in the week. And our guys went over there and got the job done and really proud of that effort. And we've got a big few weeks to go coming into finals. And, you know, we want to push for that top four. We know that that's where we need to finish. And yeah, the burn's certainly still alive and well after, certainly after last season, the way we finished in that prelim really hurt. So I know that, yeah, our guys are really fighting for that top four finish and hopefully pushing for a flag.
Trav, we salute you. Make Friday night a great one. Well done on all you've achieved so far.
I appreciate it, guys. Thank you so much.
Travis Boak ahead of game 300. What a beauty he's been.
Star. He's an icon and role model gets thrown around a bit, but there is one right there. Looking forward to watching it.
All right. Bit more to come tonight and then tomorrow night. We'll set up for round 19. The win.